All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to hit
Sideways.
The live cameras in just 1 minute.
Hamburger.
Everyone hang tight.
Virtual Entertainment Programming Network, TVEPN.com. Studios, The Slam Show. And now, your host, Slam.
Yes, happy new year to everyone out there. Welcome to the debut episode of The Slam Show 2014. And what a debut episode we are about to walk into. I just have my heart beating 100 miles an hour.
Like your shirt?
Basically.
Kid in a candy store.
You see that? You see that, ladies and gentlemen? It is the Iron Man t-shirt in full effect. It was my own personal birthday gift to myself. Yes, I had to get it because it was cool, and it makes me feel like Tony Stark, but not necessarily the billionaire part. Yep. Welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining us. Wow. Before I get into anything, let's just go ahead and have my co-hosting air personality staff introduce themselves.
I'm the lovely Lady Sage.
Come on, Gramps.
I'm Miles. How you doing?
DJ Stallion.
Hi, Miles. I like that.
You gotta wake him up.
I told you need to stick to Mac Miles.
All right. Mac Miles.
There
you
go.
It's all good. It's all good. And our special guests in the house, air personalities, they're going to kick it the entire show. We have in the middle, up-and-coming R&B artist, a good friend of mine here from the Pittsburgh area. Let's have a big round of applause for JC.
Yeah,
there we go.
Next to him is, gosh, the Bruce Lee of DJing, the Michael Jordan of DJing, the MJ, Michael Jackson of DJing. There's no need to get into any details. The legendary DJ Q-Bert in studio.
Big Q.
Boing. That's the way we fucking get down here on the Slam Show. Big time.
No
to kick it off.
Bar. Damn, you 2014.
I'm just so ecstatic because I have an individual that I helped start his career a few years back. He's humble. He wanted to return to kick off this program. And I have a freaking celebrity DJ that I've always looked up to. Thousands, millions of people throughout the galaxy has been honoring this gentleman.
Wait, who's that guy again? I'm just kidding.
Super cute.
As he told you personally, I'm rich in a very humble way. But everyone knows him as DJ Q-Bert. Gentlemen, thank you for being able to make it.
Thank you for having me.
And it's... I don't know how to start this, man, because it's just...
You've been speechless the whole time.
I have been. I can't... I'm really, really happy that we've been doing this show for over 2 years and to be able to upgrade each and every week with high-quality guests that have something to offer, whether it's something productive in their business or something that has to do with philanthropy or volunteering or anything. It's just a great vehicle for everyone to come together. And also bringing in the new co-host, such as Miles, to join us in this fun. This is actually what your
fourth. We have to clap louder because he can't hear.
Not with my bunny ears on.
That's right.
Because he's old.
He's going to bring his Beast by Dre next week.
Hey, okay. I'm going to have to.
Hey, Miles, you just have to like really like shrug him like hard.
Oh, trust me. It's coming.
He's going to bring Crosby's next week. New headphones.
I feel like I was demoted to the kid table over here. You know?
You feel demotion when you're all the way there?
Well, next,
because you're always table. Next to Sage.
I'm on
that's
the
why.
You mean you're so old, you're young again?
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of like the video games. You just turn it over when you play it so much.
What's his name? Benjamin Button?
Yeah.
That's too much, guys. That's too much.
Flip the game.
And Miles was able to contribute with some good eats earlier.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
thank you. Thank you.
Homemade.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah. It tastes like it.
Yeah.
I'll claim that.
Potato chips.
Know no different.
No difference
I'll
at all.
I'll hide the receipt.
All right. Well, before we get into anything, I'd like to talk briefly about last week's guest. It was last week, right? Yeah.
I can't remember.
It was last year.
Last year.
We didn't have one last week.
Yeah, so we had Rome come by, recording artist out of Fresno, and he actually gave you props, JC, because I guess you guys are going to collaborate and do some stuff. And obviously you work with Clayton William on some music.
Yeah.
We're going to touch on that a little later when we do your exclusive interview segment. But yeah, as far as Rome, or as Sage would say, Romy. He was a cool guy.
He was great. Yeah,
personality was definitely off
very
the hook.
Very down-earth guy. Yeah. We went to school together.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're also from Fresno?
No, I'm from here, but I went to school in Fremont.
Oh.
Yeah, it's actually Fremont. It's from Fremont.
Gotcha. Yeah. Because, wait a second, I thought you were from the Bird.
When I moved back here.
Gotcha.
And so I went to school out there. And, Rome and I were really good friends in school. So.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Cool. Yeah. So he was giving you props and so forth.
Awesome.
As far as the interview, he was great. Good personality. He was joining in on all the topics and so forth. Sage, Stalin, Miles, what'd you think
of him? Well, actually, he didn't join in on the sports part because he doesn't even know football.
Yeah, and he was very straight up with that.
Yes.
Yeah. No,
all
wrong
he
with
said
that.
Was Niners.
And that's the right thing to say.
Yeah. You don't want to say the R word up in here.
Hint.
Your mic will get turned right off real quick.
So.
What's that? What R word is that, though?
You know what it means.
It rhymes with traitor.
Yeah.
Faders. Skaters.
Those Raiders.
Maters.
And it's not the turntable group either.
Raider Nation.
No, I thought he was really good. He was a good guy to hang out with,
mm-hmm.
and he stayed for quite a while after, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, took some good photos. No, he was good.
Unlike earlier today where we're all taking photos before.
Yeah. Someone's a little excited over here.
Oh, we're all excited.
Pre-game photos.
Sounds like a 12-year-old at a Bieber concert.
Justin sure Timberlake.
Is.
Did you do it?
Yes, he did.
No. Wait, we have some special effects going on.
Cue's on point.
Yeah.
Love it. So, Stallion.
Yeah, he was a cool dude. He was a... His video reminded me like Johnny Z a little bit when I said that to him, and he goes, yeah, I know Johnny. He got that old school vibe, you know, when he's doing his thing, which is cool. I like the old school. So,
well, he's with he's actually Rome with Sublime, right? So he gets that old school feel. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very, very happy of his success.
Right. So yeah, overall it was a good show, and yeah, I'm looking forward to having him back on a future program. So let's break it down, man. We had a good weekend and so forth with the whole Niner game and the whole Niner empire. Shouts out to Joe for putting together a great event. It was off the hook. It was really cool. You missed out, Miles.
Yeah, well, you know, wife wasn't feeling all that well, so we... Yeah, not that I did not watch the game. Watch the game.
Hey, Family first.
Yeah.
There you go.
Actually, let's give a few shout-outs, because not only Joe that put the whole, who was the head guy of Niner Empire, there was also the Fairfield chapter.
One Pac.
Hayward chapter, Richmond, and if I missed anyone, I'm sorry, but all the Niner Empire chapters, shout-out to you guys.
Absolutely. Yeah. It was a great, great event.
Tupac was there, too. They call him One Pac.
Okay.
Okay, Q, man, see, you should be the sound engineer for our show.
Need, that's what we need, sound behind it. Yeah.
Because you are.
This is actually what I do.
A sound effects guy? So that's what he is.
Yeah. A little bit more than that.
Anal scratch it, too.
Yeah. Anal scratch it?
That's what I heard.
That's something they did back in the day.
Oh brother, this is incredible.
It's gonna be a good show. You're gonna make Sam's year. Oh, what can you do to top this?
It's done. Really? It's
done. Here's already claiming the best show of 2014.
Oh, wow.
This show.
That's why I took pictures before.
Yeah. Well, guys, we're gonna go ahead and take a quick commercial break and go right into the topics because we got a lot of stuff to discuss. Because I'm just so stoked right here on the Slam Show. Everyone, stay tuned.
Cash now. Call 1-800-CAR-TITLE to borrow $2,500 to $50,000 against the value of your vehicle. 1-800-CAR-TITLE has been offering the lowest rates and monthly payments for over 10 years. Mention promo code FREEWAY to receive free gas with your loan. 1-800-227-8485. 1-800-CAR-TITLE, a proud supporter of the Freeway Series.
1-800-CAR-TITLE, fast cash and low payments every day.
It's hurricane and wildfire season again. Why do thousands of people sit in these reoccurring problem areas year after year, betting their lives that the disaster won't get them? Hundreds of you helped eFoods Direct ship 50,000 donated meals to the Oklahoma victims. The problem is we can't help everybody. If every one of us who can will take care of ourselves, we can all pitch in to take care of those who really can't. The new Just In Case pack from eFoods Direct is the big brother to the 7-day emergency pack designed for Oklahoma disaster donations. It contains a 2-month supply for one person, or a 1-month supply for two adults, or a 2-week supply for a family of four. The $320 price is $50 less than retail. Call 800-409-5633 on the web eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Order two or more, get 10% off, free shipping applies. Call 800-409-5633 on the web eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
Protecting your home with a security system is a must. But when it comes to protecting your family, your home, and belongings, there's no need to sign a long-term contract. Listen, there is some real scum in the alarm business cashing in by locking you into long, punishing contracts. Not with Simply Safe Home Security. They're the good guys. You can trust Simply Safe to protect your family. Simply Safe was created by a Harvard Business School engineer, and it's revolutionary. You'll get 24-hour protection for just $14.99 a month. There are no hidden fees and no contracts. You'll save thousands. Plus, you're protected by their 100% money-back guarantee. Protect yourself against home invasions and break-ins. Order your Simply Safe system now and receive a wireless keychain remote, a $25 gift, free. So don't waste your time dealing with scum. Visit GetSimplySafe.com. GetSimplySafe.com. GetSimplySafe.com.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with a new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Taking a family of five to the amusement park can cost a small fortune.
Oh, yeah. So to save some money, we thought, hey, let's bring the amusement park to us.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
All right. Step right up. Step right up, young man. Are you ready to ride the Wacky Waterfall?
That's just the bathtub with the shower head running.
Nope, it's the Wacky Waterfall.
It's the shower, Dad.
Waterfall.
Wacky.
There's an easier way to save. To get a free rate quote, go to Geico.com. Then buy online, over the phone, or at your local Geico office.
You know the U.S. dollar is devaluing. You can see it happening every day. You know a new currency will take over at some point. Wouldn't you like to be in on the ground floor? Bitcoins. They're a decentralized, anonymous internet currency. They're free to use, free to accept, and free from inflation forever. You can use them anywhere in the world, and their value seems only to be increasing. Find out more at weusecoins.org. Don't be kicking yourself in the pants in a month. Your dollars are going down. Bitcoins are going up. Weusecoins.org.
Snoring. It's not just something to laugh about. Snoring could be a symptom of sleep apnea, a serious condition where breathing stops during sleep. And if left untreated, can lead to daytime drowsiness while driving, high blood pressure, acid reflux, heart attack, and stroke. Plus, the family issues of the snoring keeping others up all night. The first step in treatment is a sleep study. Through homeapneatest.com, it can now be done in your own home in the comfort of your own bed through the direction of a board-certified sleep medicine physician in your area. The test simply monitors your breathing while you sleep. For more information about sleep apnea, go to homeapneatest.com or call 1-877-54-APNEA.
You're like
1-877-542-7632.
When you're in the studio so much, you want to hear your homeapneatest.com.
Testing
mic,
is covered
so
by Medicare and most insurance plans.
Yes, welcome back to the Slam Show. Don't worry, Q-Bert just had a little intermission. He'll be right back. But before we go into anything.
Here he's coming. He's coming.
He's coming. He's coming. Duck. Duck. There he goes. This is the sports and news segment sponsored by Niner Empire. Because they hooked it up this past weekend over at the Niner Gathering in Fairfield when the San Francisco 49ers won. Basically won. They didn't do a freaking blowout or kill the Packers. They won on a field goal to win the game and send them to Carolina to face
and what
the Panthers.
A hell of a game. Jeez.
Where did you watch it at?
The house. Actually, I was at the Niner Empire with all the stuff you were throwing out there. Mm-hmm. I felt like I was there. Okay.
Really?
Yeah, on Facebook. You had all kinds of stuff on Facebook. So I felt like I was there. Thank you, Sam.
Okay.
Way to keep them involved.
It was the coldest game in history, right?
Yeah.
One of the coldest.
One of the coldest.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And
it wasn't quite negative or below zero. It was just, it went down to 2 degrees.
Yeah.
Same thing.
So I thought it was 10 degrees.
I'm from the minus area, 10 dude. That's
kickoff.
Not cool.
Wow. With wind chill. With the wind chill was minus 10 at kickoff.
Oh, my Lord.
So what's that cold? You don't even notice 2 degrees. You don't notice anything. You're like, whoa.
Yeah, past a certain.
You're numb.
Yeah. Actually, I'm looking at the screen right now. It was 4 degrees.
Four?
Yeah.
Yeah.
In that neighborhood. But overall.
Imagine getting hit.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Overall, it was a great event. Props out to Joe, Niner Empire, Monica, his wife, and the entire staff. It was just beautiful. Just the atmosphere there. Noah Coughlin. My cousin, the one that walked across America, he was there to represent as well.
Yes, yeah. I've seen him there.
Yeah. He was there half the time. I don't know why he took off after half.
Yeah.
He bossed us.
Had to walk around the block.
Shit.
Walking home.
But yeah, things look good for the Niners. They're just going to go over there to Carolina, beat their asses, and hopefully they'll either play the Saints or the Seahawks.
Ooh. Well, they play the Saints. They'll be back at Frisco, right? So
yes, yeah.
Which will be nice. Okay, now are they going to play at Candlestick again?
Yeah, if it's the Saints.
It'll be the last game.
Okay.
Yeah, but if
Seattle
really
wins, was the last regular season game. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. Oh, I like your football pedigree.
We want on the Saints, so we can go to that game. We'll sneak in.
We're gonna sneak in.
How are we going to sneak in?
She wants to know.
We say we know Q-Bert. They'll let us in.
Okay. Double rock side.
Oh, dude. When you do like a mix set there on the stadium, whoo, they can't say no to that. That's for sure.
They'll just say boo. Entourage.
Yeah, the entourage, yes.
Yeah. Overall, I love the Niners' chances to go all the way. Having Kaepernick show off his arms and just totally take over. Yeah.
His running ability is great.
I mean, that was freezing cold.
Yeah.
Trade seats with you.
It was freezing cold.
Take your arms off.
And here's the thing. The NFL, they really, really want a good show for Super Bowl. And if they're going to have
Bruno Mars, man, opening.
Oh, no. No, he's doing halftime.
Halftime, I mean. Yeah.
He's doing halftime.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
You show his nipple.
That was the best Super Bowl ever.
most watched halftime and then rewatched.
But you know what? I really, really want the Niners to play the Seahawks at the final Super Bowl game, only because we crave that drama.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, so
I have a buddy that plays for
Seattle. I really want that to happen.
You have a buddy?
Yeah. Went to school with him, Robert Turbin.
Really?
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah, Irvington.
That's cool.
Yeah, so he's doing great.
You got to hit him up and freaking get some tickets from his ass.
All right,
something. But yeah, I'm very excited. I think the Niners are going to take it all the way. I got a good feeling about
this. Who do you think they're
going to play? Probably the Seahawks. But they for sure are going to beat the Panthers. That's a done deal.
You guys didn't beat them last time.
No, they can't play.
By 1 point. By 1 point.
Loss is a loss.
Hey, that's true. So we'll see how
but
that plays out.
But the Niners always redeem themselves. So
yeah,
it's going to be a guaranteed
true.
Win.
That's true. There you go.
Guaranteed. Lady Sage said it.
Oh, you got a sound effect there, Q?
No, it didn't come out that time.
All right.
Oh. So where are you gonna watch Sunday's
that's
game?
That's what she said.
What was that, Miles?
Where are you going to watch Sunday's game?
At your house.
Yeah, your place.
Breakfast in bed.
It's an early start, 10 a.m.
Yeah, 10 a.m.
Oh, man. Still snoozing then.
We're not going to do some type of party over there at your place? I haven't been to your house yet.
No, not yet.
Yeah. No. Let's make it happen.
Might have to do a sleepover.
Mm-hmm. Might have to.
Hey, slow down
there. I have a crib for you.
Either you.
Baby's room still set up.
It's because I'm younger than you.
Hey,
by
that's
a lot
right.
of years. A
lot of years.
You got that walk-in tub?
Oh, my God.
With the handrails?
Yep. He can't miss his house. He's the only one with a ramp going to the front door.
That's so beautiful.
And a handicap sign in the driveway.
Q, we need the sound effect for that one.
Oh.
Yeah, that was perfect. Oh, wow.
Too late.
That's beautiful. But yeah, Niners, I predict, are going to go all the way. This was a tremendous showing, and it's going
to
happen.
But, you know, it was a really good game, too, this Sunday's game. That was a great game to watch all the way to the end.
It was.
I mean, it was a nail-biter.
I'm a Raiders fan, and that was a really good game.
Yeah.
You guys never.
I just had to say that.
Yeah, you had to because you guys never had a really good game yet.
Oh, I mean, quest for six since '94, right?
When's the last time you won a Super Bowl? Were you even born?
But doesn't matter. Doesn't matter though.
Were you born?
Doesn't matter.
I'm just asking.
No matter how far you went,
you were born in '88.
Did you win?
Yeah. Let's cut this conversation. It's crickets.
Yeah, yeah.
You were born in '88.
Yeah, '88.
When was the last time the Raiders won a Super Bowl? Raider fan?
not in 88.
Oh, gentlemen. The
but the colors are cool. I like the colors.
Yeah.
The patch. I like the eye patch.
And the other eye is closed.
All right. This is going to go right up Q's alley on this next topic. Check it out. Last week, there was a crop circle that made the news. It was over by a field in Gilroy. And it looks something like this. Everyone was tripping because it just came out of nowhere.
Is it Gilroy or Salinas?
In that area.
That shit's inside of Drake's head.
Wow.
So everyone's thinking the obvious.
That looks like a football field.
The Niners are going to play next.
That's actually the Raiders' new stadium.
It's a tape recorder.
So, yeah, this crop circle just popped out of nowhere, and all kinds of viral videos were put together, people passing by saying, oh, we've seen green lights before this actually came to fruition. And as it turned out, guys, it was actually a marketing ploy. Not my shirt, unfortunately.
Big time. And it got enough publicity.
Crazy. Yeah. NVIDIA is the maker of all the smart chips and all that good stuff for phones and so forth. They're the ones responsible for it because I'll put up a image here, and there you go. There's the chip. Exact replica of the crop circle that was put out. There's the chip. There's the crop circle. Wow.
I'd love to know how much they paid for that.
Check that out. Guys, what a promotional ploy. Ain't that?
Marketing's everything, man.
Who would have thought of creating a freaking crop circle and making it connected.
Well, especially this far out from when it was really popular, when they were all out. Mm-hmm. What's it been, 10, 15 years since the last crop circle actually?
No. Let's ask Q on that because I'm pretty sure he's on top
Q,
of that.
When was the last crop circle?
Oh, I don't know, but I do know that, yeah, you're right. That is by NVIDIA. They announced that at the CES show the other day.
Mm-hmm.
And also on Coast to Coast last night, they said that.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. George
Norrie. You also watch Coast to Coast?
Yeah. That's my favorite show.
Yes. George Norrie.
Surprise Miles didn't know. Area 51. Shit, you were there, right?
Yeah, I think it's a very good effort by the corporation to go ahead. But if you look at it, how it's done, it's so intricate. I don't care if it's a freaking fake alien contraption. Just to execute how the crop circle is made is just phenomenal. And just making the size and everything so precise. Because they're out there. I don't know how they do it.
Well, they have GPS now. They just program it into GPS and they'll follow the GPS.
Oh, kind of like a little robotic thing?
The tractors will just follow a GPS.
Oh!
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you for clarifying that.
Yeah, I was going to say, well, they use the geometry of the XY axis. And
I'd love to know how much they paid for that.
I know some guys from Home Depot came out there. And,
well, that's what I was thinking. That's what I was thinking. There's some footage of people like walking on 2x4s and making all the impressions for the crop circle effect. So
no, this one was actually mowed down. They showed a clip on it. And they were actually in the tractors.
The one that you're talking about where they put the 2x4, it's the corn.
Yeah.
It's for the corn crop circles, not the lawn or whatever.
It was the wheat. This one here was done on, forget what field it was. No. I forget, not barley. I forget.
It is barley.
Was it barley?
Yeah, it's a barley field.
Barley field, yeah.
Yeah. So let's kind of concentrate on why they did it. It was for the 192 super chip, which is the next generation chip. As far as that's concerned, I think every freaking new computer is fast. I don't see any major difference.
Why didn't they put their logo?
When?
No, why didn't they?
Well, because that was the whole viral intention, is to make everyone kind of like, ooh, who created this? So, yeah, I'm sort of excited. I'd like to see how fast this processor is.
Yeah, how much faster they can go.
Yeah. I mean, what's the next thing? And we talked about that before, where pretty soon, eventually, teleportation is going to be possible.
Yeah.
I mean, who would have thought, Q, back in the day, when we had vinyl and tape, that now you could just put something on your computer and send it to the Philippines instantaneously? Who would have thought
that's
that?
That's crazy. That's crazy. In the future, they're going to have, like, you know, quartz crystals. They can hold, like, I don't know, what's bigger than a terabyte?
We got our 2 terabytes.
Well, yeah, like you can hold like a zillion terabytes in like a little
2 terabytes, right?
Finding out.
Would you say Tara Patrick? I mean,
Q knew that one real quick. Tara Patrick Charmaine Star can't go wrong.
We all know a terabyte's 1,000 gigabytes. I mean, yeah.
Right. And in connection to that, they're saying that that's why they're saying the crystal skulls are basically a computer because it's in there somehow, which is like...
Crystal skulls right over there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, get some skull. Right
there. Well, just like what you guys did when you wanted him to give you some music, you just put it on a little thumb drive. Who would have thought you can just plug it in, do it, send it, and give it to you, and you could have took it anywhere. Put it in here, put it in there, and...
That's what she
years
said.
Ago. And it was so easy to put it in and out, too. Yeah. And out.
That's how you did it back in the day.
Download, put it in and out. Download, put it in and out.
Very small.
But yeah, sky's the limit. And we're going to get into that when we do the Cuber exclusive interview because he's all into extraterrestrial and all that good stuff.
You seen the one I put up on the moon? Why they haven't gone back yet?
Oh, the little creature coming out of the craters and so that forth? Good. That's funny. That's real funny. So, yeah, there you go. A corporation did all that crazy stuff on the crop circles. I thought it was going to be real aliens. Disappointed. Oh, well. Next one. All right. Moving on to our final topic. LMFAO is being sued by Rick Ross. Of the track. Well, the statement, little saying that they use on Party Rock Anthem, every day I'm shuffling. Well, that's from Rick Ross's song,
Hustlin'.
And he says it in that way. Kind of weird, isn't it? It came out in 2010.
That's
and
what I was about to say. Hasn't the song, like, not really being played anymore?
Well, he didn't need money back then. He does now.
That too. Yeah. Also, the way I'm looking at everything and all the details, he basically planned it out and waited until the whole branding of LMFAO got big with the t-shirts and the items and so forth, and that's when he went after him. Because you see all those shirts every day I'm shuffling.
Yeah.
Well, that's the staple right there. And Rick Ross is suing. It's just weird. I mean, can't you just give him a call and work it out?
To be such a thug and going in the law.
What's up? Hey.
LMFAO stole Rick Ross's lyrics. Rick Ross stole somebody's life.
Okay. That was Rich.
He works for LMFAO.
Oh, okay. We'll talk more about that. I wish we had more info on the secret background of Rich. We might throw him on the open stool later on after the break.
Yeah, that was hard. Rich,
he makes like apps for the company. He just made an app for actually Shortcut just texted him right now.
Oh, he's
making an app for him in
DC. Shortcut.
That's right. John, what's going on? But yeah, it's kind of timely because you're trying to freaking do your thing, and next thing you know, 2 years, 4 years later, someone's gonna say, "Hey, we want to get some money." It's like, fuck, I had that song forever.
Shuffling and hustling is two different words.
Yeah, it's the phrase in how the it's being used.
The way he puts it in the content.
Exactly. That's so, greedy. Do you think Rick Ross is kind of going overboard with this?
Yes. Absolutely. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's petty.
Very petty.
It's very petty.
Not with the amount of money that he's gonna get, ain't petty. But
he ain't gonna get shit.
Yeah. Is it? I doubt that he'll get much out of it. I doubt that fight will stand.
Really? You're confident about that, JC?
Yeah, I think it is.
It's like, do a feature on my track. Oh, cool. Let me do one on yours. We'll call it even.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, you got the sons and the nephew of Berry Gordy. Mm, and then you got...
That's right.
Rick Ross. Mm-hmm. Who just did a album or a song with Jay-Z.
That's right.
That's getting ready to launch, and it's already got so much publicity, and downloads are crazy. So it's like, you don't need the money. So I think it's a publicity stunt.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be...
Just blown over.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Well said.
Yeah. We'll see how that plays out. And...
From the music
It makes
side.
Everybody relevant.
Yeah, you know exactly.
I mean? Oh, this person's fighting with this person. This person's fighting controversy
sells.
Yeah,
oh,
definitely.
Yeah. A lot.
Yeah. I mean, I'm pretty sure they sit around in a conference
Let's
room.
Start a beef.
I want to start a beef with someone in this room.
Don't look my way.
Look right at Miles.
Yeah.
Well, my eyes went around this way.
Uh-huh.
So, Q, do you think he's out of line for making this little lawsuit
happen? Well, yes, but, you know, at the same time, everyone's going to get what they deserve. So, win or lose, he's, you know, whatever... Yeah. You know, God, the universe knows what they're going to deserve, so money doesn't really matter anyway, if you think of it like that.
Mm, well said.
And it puts Rick Ross right up in the news again and puts him out there. Now, all of a sudden, he comes out with a new album, like
yeah,
you said.
It could be a publicity stunt, too.
Yeah. And
they might even actually be working together.
Oh, yeah, most could. Definitely.
Yeah.
That's right.
It's two of the biggest entities in music right now. Like, that's why I don't understand, you know, Wale, who's signed to Maybach Music.
Mm-hmm.
Omarion, who's signed to Maybach Music.
That's right.
Those are the two biggest artists right now, a couple of the biggest artists.
Yeah.
Omarion taking over the R&B and, like, I guess you can call it ratchet R&B
right,
side.
Right.
And Wale, he's just on top of the world with his verses and his hooks. Like,
very
everybody's,
true.
You know, and obviously Rick Ross gets a percentage of all that.
Mm-hmm.
So you got two of the biggest people in the industry, plus whatever you're doing with Jay-Z. Like, you don't need that money. So, you know, I think it's just
a publicity stunt.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see how this plays out. And if there's any follow-up information, I'll be sure to bring it to you here on the
I'm sure we can name about 30 songs right now that someone took a hook from a hook or a scene from a movie
or
a scene from...
Everything's recycled.
Yeah.
Everything's recycled.
A scene from an old song. You know, I mean, it's just...
I mean, how many people has sampled Planet Rock from Africa Bambaataa?
Yeah.
Everyone. And
yeah, everybody.
Including myself.
But I'm just saying, like, a verse, like a word, not even like an instrumental or a beat, just a word, a phrase, and flipping that phrase, making it sound the same but different.
That's right.
I mean, there's tons of songs out there like that.
Mm-hmm.
And, it seems like with my generation of music, it's like everybody's it's like everybody's taking the old school, they're taking the whole verse or the whole hook and putting it to a new age beat, and then they're calling it theirs.
Mm-hmm.
And you can normally get in trouble for that. You're supposed to go through some channels to get, you know,
to
get
research.
That permission. But, you know, I've heard some reputable people even putting out music videos with it, you know, so.
Yeah.
Or just pay for it.
Yeah, well, you could pay for it, but.
You don't see Stallone soon in Rocky,
yeah.
You know, going, hey, that's mine, you know. And I'm putting his picture on the album and stuff. I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Yep. It becomes very shady, but at the same time, it's all workable. You just contact the publicist, contact the agent, make it work. You don't have to sue anyone.
Yeah.
But like you guys are saying, it's just all for publicity. It's all for the websites to go viral. It makes news. Makes you relevant.
Yeah.
There you go. All right, we're going to go ahead and take a quick music break and be back with our exclusive interview with Up and Coming. R&B artist JC here on The Slam Show. Everyone hang tight. I think we spotted him.
Sasquatch, please check the watch. This is Bigfoot, don't get it shook. Out in Japan, they call me Godzilla. Up in Africa, King Kong Gorilla. Michael Joe Jackson, used to call me Thriller. All my enemies, swear I'm Attila. Vietnam vet, burn down your villa. Captain Crunch screams, serial killer. Out in Oak Town, I'm a fucking pirate. Think I'm Rodney King? We can start a riot. To a fat bitch, I'm a fucking diet. You a solitary, I'm peace and quiet. This a nightmare, on Elm Street. Just to run away, where the pimps be. You's a thirsty man, I'm so empty. At your funeral, no sympathy. They call me Sasquatch, please check the watch. This is Bigfoot, don't get it shook. Out in Japan, they call me Godzilla. Up in Africa, King Kong Gorilla.
The encounters are terrifying.
It was all hairy, from head to toe.
Thousands have reported seeing this beast.
You just gotta see it to believe it.
The evidence has been elusive. Until now.
They call me Sasquatch. Please check the watch. Please check the time. I'm like turpentine. And it's bourbon time. You exhausted, I know. Cause I'm overtime. And I'm over the line. Come over to mine. I already left. You want to rhyme, bitch? I'm social deaf. You ready to shine? I'm already blind. You already lying. A nigga ain't buying what you selling. Always open 7-Eleven when I flow. Niggas know. Here come tsunami. You got a bucket list. My list is Bugatti. You that drowning kid at the pool party. I'm that carnivore over your body. They call me Sasquatch. Please check the watch. This is Bigfoot. Don't get it shook. Out in Japan, they call me Godzilla. Up in Africa, King Kong Gorilla.
Don't make me put this foot up in your ass.
Don't do it,
don't make me put this foot up in your ass.
Don't make me put this foot up in your ass.
What you do, bring it on down and give me my cash.
You's a fucking prick, but I'm Moby Dick. I'm Darth Vader, you Obi-Wan Kenobi, bitch. He's Jim Kelly, y'all. I'm Terry Bradshaw. He is baby ass. I'm like diaper rash. I'm like stinking trash. I'm like party crash. Like getting caught with hash. I'm like your stolen cash. I like you feeling bad. They call me Slap Rock. I like the whole country looking at the dead clock. Pyroclastic flow, this is Pompeii. Whoever in the way, turn you into clay. Call me out my name, and that's a hurricane. I'll send the wind and the water and the pouring rain. I am boring, man. I am snoring, man. I'm the pain that's wearing off the Novocaine. I'm the weight you gain. I make your titties hang. I'm that color train that just hit the man. They call me Sasquatch. Please check the watch. This is Bigfoot. Don't get it shook. Out in Japan, they call me Godzilla. Up in Africa, King Kong Gorilla. They call me Sasquatch. Please check the watch. This is Bigfoot. Big, don't get it shook. Out in Japan, they call me Godzilla.
Yeah, that's brand new Ice Cube Sasquatch. Can you figure that out in this very paranormal extraterrestrial version?
I bet you he doesn't even know that a Sasquatch is from is intergalactic.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Oh. He was like, yep,
brought a
he
new
is.
One to me.
He is. All right. Welcome back, everyone, to The Slam Show. This is our exclusive interview segment, part one. Yes. And we're going to start off with this gentleman. He's from the Pittsburgh, Fremont area. He is an up-and-coming R&B artist. He's working with one of the hottest producers in the Bay, Clayton William.
Clayton William, huh?
Clayton William. And what's this going on here on the video? This is from a performance of yours?
Yeah. Yeah, that was Love Rant's performance.
All right. All right.
Yeah, shout out to Love Rant.
There you go.
Had me out there, so I opened up for him. Yeah, it was a cool show.
Cool. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for JC, everyone.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Instead of manually clapping,
the tech man is on the scene.
Q is on point. I love him. JC.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for being able to make it.
Thank you for having me.
We met, what, 4 years ago? Something like that?
Oh, seven.
Or longer.
Oh, seven.
Golly,
yeah.
Time flies, brother. Yeah. You're looking good.
Thank you.
It looks everything. I'm going to sit next to Q, man.
Aren't you already?
Yeah, like, you want to hold his hand?
You want some? Hey, let me get some of that.
How close you want to be?
He said he wants to switch seats with him because he doesn't want to sit next to you anymore.
Well, from the viewer's standpoint, we're in different rooms. So, yeah, I could still get away with that. So, basically, let's talk about the whole music thing now. Because you got connected with Clayton William.
Yeah.
He is the bomb producer that's making stuff happen.
Killing shit right now, yeah. Definitely.
How did that connection go?
Long story. Like, I got a job after being released from prison. I got a job as a car detailer.
Mm-hmm.
And then a buddy of mine that I got close with, he said, hey, I'm going to go do this record. It's out in San Bruno. Maybe you can come and help me write it. So he was sick that day, and so I helped him write it, and then he had me demo it.
Mm-hmm.
And then from that point, Clay was like, yo, I want to work with you, like, you know. So
it was, oh, so he was forward about it.
Yeah, it was a fluke, you know, like I wasn't even supposed to be singing. I was just supposed to be writing.
Yeah.
And then my buddy said, go in there and demo it for me. And so I went in there, I demoed it, and then Clay and I just hooked up from there, and that's how it happened.
Yeah.
So wow. Just it was supposed to happen. Yeah, right.
Right,
yeah.
On. So this track, prior to it, what was the vibe with the whole music thing? Were you really like into making it develop, or was it like, okay, I got my priorities in a certain place?
Well, the first track, which was you seen on the video there,
mm-hmm.
Is featuring R.O.D. Huge for I Can't Stand You. 2010 was like the number one song in the Bay Area, R&B
right.
song. And like I said, when I got home, that was the first R&B song I heard. And that was even before I met Clay. And I heard it and I fell in love with the track because it was so real. You know, I was listening to everything on the radio. And like I said, you know, like we talked about before, you know, I was born 88. So I was raised in the 90s.
You like to emphasize that a
yeah,
lot.
Yeah, I love to emphasize that because I need people to know where I stand
yeah.
with the music.
Yeah, know? Like you just woke up and said, hey, I want to sing R&B.
Yeah,
and
I'm inspired by the likes of Babyface and Luther Vandross and Jodeci and
Shy.
Yeah, and DNH and Legacy. You know what I mean?
Michael Bolton.
R&D was singing some real shit.
Yeah.
So I was like, man, that's where I want to be, you know? And so I finally, like I said, by the grace of God, hooked up with Clay. And he shot me a beat, and he said, let me know what you think about this. So I heard it. I loved it. It made me feel some type of way. And I wrote the song. Now, and the song that I was writing is called Stop Tripping.
Mm-hmm.
And it kind of played off of what R.O.D. was saying with, you know, I can't stand you. I'm tired of you. I'm in the studio every night. You tripping. And I'm like, yo, it would be awesome to have R.O.D. So I reached out to him.
Right.
And I told him, you know, I'm trying to pick up the pieces here, you know, just being really straightforward. I'm trying to pick up the pieces here. I'm an R&B singer from the Bay Area, yada, yada, yada. And I didn't expect him to hit me back, but thank God for real people out here, you know, that he hit me back. And
that comes through with their word.
He's like, yeah, exactly. And he hit me back and he's like, so what are you trying to do? And then I shot him my concept.
Mm-hmm.
And then I shot him the lyrics that I had wrote. And he goes, I love it. He's like, all right, so you know, let's work, you know. So I laid down my part, and then he came through to lay down his part.
Mm-hmm.
And then I wanted to be in the studio because I wanted to at least get that vibe, even though I had finished my part already. And then he was actually going to do the bridge. And he's like, man, why don't you go ahead and knock out the bridge? He's like, you know, you just knock it out. And I'll do the harmonies. And, you know, I'll do ad-libs. And, you know, I'll do whatever it takes to help you. And I was like, man, you know, that showed me right there that there's people still out there who appreciate the music.
Right.
And so that made me hungrier.
Mm-hmm.
But
we talked about that, too, about how the culture of music nowadays is way different from what you wanted to do.
Yeah, yeah.
With the whole Babyface 5, the non-auto-tune thing. And this track that we're going to play in a little bit is sort of like on the new generation R&B with the auto-tune and the tweaking out.
Yeah.
How do you take that and how are you going to move forward with it for your album?
Well,
you want to have both, maybe some of the old-school style?
Yeah, you know, I kind of like... I'm kind of going to probably play more to my Gemini that, you know, I'll give you like the pretty boy, you know, the romantic, the guy that you can take home.
Right, right.
And then the guy that you don't want to take home, but you want to take home. You know what I mean? You don't want to take on a mom, but you want to take home, you know, just to give you that edge and then just to give you that smooth. So some things on the album for everybody. Yeah. So right now we're just going to keep doing, I guess the new phrase of it is ratchet R&B.
Okay.
So, we do ratchet R&B and then... I'm going to follow it up with more R&B.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. And we're going to go ahead and get into that track. You wrote this entire thing, and what was the inspiration behind it?
I actually co-wrote it.
Okay.
Like I said, you know, my mind doesn't go to this place of this music. It is now, you know, because I'm around the right people to help me get there. But the rapper on it, Miller, shout out to Miller. I actually reached out to him. I said, yo, man, honestly... my mind doesn't process this, so I need your help. I need to get around you. I need to kick it with you. I need to drink with you. I need to smoke, whatever, you know. I don't smoke, but, you know, whatever. I just need to get around you and see where your mind is at, because he's on fire right now. He has, like six songs on the radio, including his own. So it's like...
You're talking about Clayton, right?
No, I'm talking about Miller.
Miller, okay.
The rapper on it.
Gotcha.
Who also works with Clayton Williams. He works with everybody else, but he's on Run with Furious.
Yeah.
He did the hook for that. He has a song called Hell Yeah. He's on Fill Your Cup Up with Cesar Gemini,
mm-hmm.
D-Mac, J-Main, Clayton. And then he also has a new one that he's coming out with as well.
Cool.
With Al and I.
Yeah. Nice.
So he's everywhere right now. So I was like, yo, I need to get with you.
Yeah.
I need to sit down and pick your brain, you know, and figure out where I fit here. And so I figured, okay, now I can take the ratchet of this R&B, and then I can use the harmonies and the vocals to smooth it out a little bit to make it more acceptable for me to do, you know, so yeah.
Yeah, because there's a fine line where you're going to draw, hey, I'm going to go all in with the ratchet R&B versus I want to stay true with some soul.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha. Well, we're going to go ahead and get into that track. It's called Hand It Over.
Hand It Over.
By Milla and featuring Jay-Z, produced by Clayton Williams.
Yep.
Here on the Slam Show. Everyone enjoy. We'll be right back.
But she wobbity, drop that shoe. Ah, how you learn that shoe? Ah, make you earn that shoe. Ah, bands don't make a dance, and they all gon' make a dance. There she go, twerking on the wall, twerking on the wall. Let her be a nigga in there. There she go, twerking on the wall, woman on the wall. Wanna beat it up, give her all this dude. Beat it from the back while I'm throwing stacks. Hit it in the Benz and the Cadillac. Gas pedal, make that rap pedal. Mess the hood up, chop her down.
like she been messing wood up.
Then she go taking on the wall, taking on the wall. Let her be a Mary in it. Then she go taking on the wall, home and on the wall. Made me wanna beat that all night. Baby, she sucks to me. You can talk it out. It's all night long. Take it all night. Yeah, she sucks to me. You can talk it out. All night long.
Yeah, that is JC's track featuring Milla, Hand It Over.
That's my boo.
That is the that's the slap right there. That's the slap.
Right on.
And
so is this what you call R&B ratchet?
We call it ratchet R&B, yeah.
Oh, ratchet R&B, okay.
Yeah. Ratchet R&B.
I mean, John Hart, whose booty is it? He's actually the one that created that ratchet R&B, I believe.
Yeah.
He's running with it.
Mm-hmm.
Me, I just say ratchet R&B for that kind of stuff because I just wouldn't see Luther Vandross singing something like that.
Right. So is it technically an official term or are you just adding on that
I'm just going on with the trend. You know,
oh, really?
That's what they're saying. It's ratchet R&B.
Okay.
So I'm like, okay, cool.
All right.
Yeah, I don't think it's a legit genre.
No. No.
You'll see it on Billboard. Ratchet R&B.
Well, you didn't think you'd see grunge either. Look.
Yeah, that's true.
Kind of like Pretty Ricky did, you know, some years ago. They did, you know.
Yeah.
That's right. And that was like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Wow, Pretty Ricky.
Q, what's so funny?
Shortcut keeps texting me funny things.
hey, Shortcut, you want to hear something funny? I got the Rain 64.
Ooh. You got his Rain 64?
I got mine. I heard he didn't get his yet.
Ooh.
Ouch.
I got it first, though.
What's the difference between the 62 and the 64?
Well, it's got four channels instead of two.
Oh, wow.
And it's got two mic inputs and a bunch of new features, new software updates.
So do you know how to use it?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's in the trunk right now.
All right. Let's go ahead and have our air personality staff ask JC some questions, starting with Sage.
All right. I'm going to freestyle this question. Okay. I do notice that you have tattoos on your arms.
Yeah.
What are the meanings behind your tattoos?
So this one is a cross with a the modern mic wrapped around it. And it's subliminal because it's always on. And above it, it says, blessed by God. And that's because I feel like people tend to forget that it's not on your will, you know, not to get too biblical, but it's not on your will. It's on his will that you have the abilities that he gave you. And I forget that. I'm guilty of forgetting that. So I have it tattered on me always to remember, like, my mic is always on for him. Everything that I do, you know, he's blessed me with the ability to do. So.
You seen that movie, Memento?
No, I haven't. Okay. I'm going to have to check it out now that you said it. Just because you're a legend.
He tattoos. When he forgets he tattoos.
Oh, wow.
On his arm.
Oh, wow. Now, are all your other tattoos music related?
This one is actually a full music strip, and it goes into an old-fashioned mic. And I keep it an old-fashioned mic, like the Etta James mic.
I think the audience is going to want to see it. Take it off.
Oh.
Or Sage wants to see it.
Take it off.
Yeah. Sage right there.
Your eyes got big all of a sudden.
Yeah.
So there you go.
It's
okay.
An old-fashioned mic.
Very nice.
Specifically,
what do you call that mic?
I don't know what I call it, man.
It's called a vintage mic.
Vintage. It's called
old-ass mic.
Miles, what's that shit called?
Specifically, I just
no,
want...
No, you didn't.
I just want to remember... I just want people to know that I appreciate, and people also to remember when they see it, that R&B comes from that mic. You know, everybody sang on that mic. That paved the way for us to be doing what we're doing today. Yeah.
Got it. Thank you very much.
Cool.
Hey, so out of all the singers like Keith Sweat, Aaron Hall, all the old schoolers,
yeah.
What's one song that you can sing word from start to finish?
Man, anything.
Like your
90,
favorite.
Man. Anything.
Like any 90. Song right now, you could sing the a cappella right now.
Shy. Oh, man. shy guy, anything.
So sing a shy song right now if I ever could fall in love.
Not the whole song, but maybe like just, a line, you know, like or something.
A hook. Yeah, a hook. That's what I'm saying. Bust it out.
Oh, he wants you to freestyle.
Yeah, we're going to freestyle.
Freestyle. No, you're not freestyling, but you're singing the acapella.
Okay. How's it start?
I got you.
I've been forgetting. Oh, sorry. Hold on. Hold on.
On the spot.
Where's my sound effect?
Right? Yeah, right. Where's your sound effect there, real quick?
Should I play it for
you?
Shy. Yeah, just do it manually.
We'll do Marvin Gaye.
The very first time that I saw your brown eyes, you only said hello and I said hi. I knew right then you were the one, but I was caught up in physical attraction. But to my satisfaction, baby, you were more than just a face.
Yeah. Sage is over there sweating. Hey, you did that right. Yeah.
Cool, cool. All right, Miles.
If there was one artist, living or dead, that you could pull out of your past, that you would love to just sit down, talk to, and sing one song with, theirs or yours,
man,
who would that one impressive person be?
Good Lord Almighty, that's a hard question.
I know there's a lot.
That's a lot.
But there got to be one that really stands out to you.
You know, the guy that really kicked it off for me, it's not him, but it's Usher. That's who kicked it off for me. I sing, I dance. So, you know, my first dance moves were Usher moves, and so I learned that. But behind him, there was Babyface. And Babyface is responsible for a lot of hits, a lot of Grammys. But his music, it empowers, it makes you cry, it makes you laugh, helps you make love. Like, you know, so...
it's a wedding song.
Exactly, right? And so to get into his mind and see how it ticks, and to maybe do when can I see you again, like just him on the guitar and me harmonizing, or just even just being in that atmosphere, I think right now that I'd have to go with Babyface.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Wow, good choice.
Yeah. Thank you.
I don't think Miles has heard that song. You might want to sing it for him.
I made many a babies to that song.
Q, take it away.
So I got two questions. What'd you get locked up for? And when you did get locked up, I noticed that everyone that comes out, they have a whole bunch of stuff written because they've been in there working, actually.
Yeah.
They like turn it into a positive.
I got locked up. I took a bid for a family member. And in doing that bid, you know, I'm from Pittsburgh. And
explain what a bid is for those that don't know.
Oh, a bid. Basically,
it's not from eBay, right?
Something.
Or two bids.
Basically, it's your. I took some time. I took some time for a family member. Basically, it just came down to me not opening my mouth. You know, and he had did something. I won't go into too much detail, but you know, he had did something. I said I didn't know what happened. Somehow, it was implemented. And I continued to say nothing. But
it's
eventually,
honorable, bro. Super honorable. Man.
You know, I came home and I told some kids, you know, they were talking to me like, hey, you know, not that they wanted to be like me, but, you know, it was a party and, you know, they were telling me like, you know, that's cool what you did. And I'm like, fuck no, it's not. Fuck no. I'm not telling you to go out there and snitch, but don't put yourself in a situation where you'd have to. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because some people don't, you know, because my son, while I was in there, was born with leukemia. Mm-hmm. He was born with leukemia. And Down syndrome. So for the hardest thing for me to do was stay quiet. You know, I'm not even going to front and say, oh, it was easy for me to stay solid. It was not. Yeah. I did it. So you can't
tell
me.
How long was your stretch?
Two. Yeah.
So you didn't snitch is what you
said? No.
Yes, that's honorable. Yeah.
But, you know, everything comes to light. Everything comes to fruition. And they found out I had nothing to do with it. I wasn't involved. And I only got 2 years instead of 27.
You know, that's what monks do. Like if a monk sees like a murder or something, and the cops come, and they ask him like who did it, the monk will say,
"Yeah,
I can't say. I'm not supposed to say.
Just I'm not involved."
Yeah. So leave it up to God.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And your second question was what?
Oh, Yeah, so you was in there and you got to write and stuff, right? Make some positive out of it.
Yeah, crazy, because we were talking about it earlier, and my bunkie, I was in San Quentin, and then I had moved down south, and my bunkie happened to be an OG named Ricky Abernathy. I call him Pop. Now, he's seen some tattoos. He's seen the music tattoo, and he asked me, he's like, "You rap?" I was like, "Nah, man, I sing." Like, nigga, you don't sing.
Straight up with
like, like, all right, you know? And so he took me outside, and he's like, "You know, sing me something." I'm like, whatever. It's something I love to do, and in my position, I don't mind doing it. It's going to at least make me happy. So I sang a song, sang John Legend's Ordinary People. I drew a crowd. He didn't expect that. So he told me, he's like, "Yeah, we're going to talk tonight." I'm like, okay. I don't give a fuck if you're P. Diddy in there. Like, it doesn't help me in here, you know. But I'm like, who is this OG? So he pulled me off my rack, my bunk, for you guys who don't know what that is. And he had papers laid out all over his bed. And he's like, "Before I show you these papers, my name is Ricky Abernathy Jr. I'm formerly the lead singer of Lakeside." And I'm like, "Whoa, yo."
Whoa.
I was like, "That sounds familiar." He's like, "Do you know who I am?" I was like, "Lakeside sounds familiar. I don't." Sounds, I was like, familiar. If I hear the music, I probably know. So he starts flipping over letters from like Charlie Wilson, pictures with Beyonce, pictures with Casey and JoJo, Casey and JoJo calling him dad, and like all these people, Whitney Houston, Bobby Brown. I'm like, what the like, that's Whitney Houston. Like, okay, I like Beyonce, but that's Whitney Houston. They don't get no bigger than that, you know? And he goes, "Well, do you know Fantastic Voyage and All the Way Live?" I was like, "Of course." He's like, "Well, those are my songs." I was like, "No shit."
What did he get put in for?
I'm not telling you that.
He didn't do it.
Everybody's innocent. That's right. Everyone's innocent.
Come on, Q.
But
these are questions people want to know, right?
Yeah. 2 years I went down for not snitching.
That's nice.
So he took care of me. Like he had me on my rack, like during times of war. Like, if I wasn't fighting, then I was on my rack every night writing a song, doing, you know. And I wrote some of the most, like, painful, hard, like, you know, you think your lady's out there cheating on you. You think, you know, now you think you're, like, you're in love. And as soon as you get out, you're going to get married. And then she don't write you in a few weeks. And you're like, man, fuck you. It's like, you know, you go through all these emotions. Your friends forget about you. And that was the hardest part, was, like, you know, your closest friends that you were down with outside, they forget that you're inside. And it hurts, but at the same time, life goes on, you know, and I come to grips with that. Like, you know, I can't hold on to that, you know. So I let all that go because it hurt me in a lot of my relationships.
Right.
But yeah, definitely. But, you know, anyway, Pops, Ricky Abernathy, he gave me a number and he said, "Here, I want you to take this number. I want you to call it when you get out." My managers that I ended up firing were Lou Rawls Jr. Ooh. And Marvin Gaye Jr. Because he was connected with them, but they were so much into like
stuff.
Drugs. Yeah, you know what I mean, and certain things that just didn't mesh well with my career. That, you know, I had to part my ways. So, but you know, they got me in front of a lot of people, but you know, right now it didn't work out. But now I got a good manager. I got one of the top producers, you know, in the Bay,
mm-hmm.
taking over, and you know, my career, and thank God, is on the uprise.
And I think you should hook up with Hubert for a track.
Oh yeah, what's up, Hubert?
You ready?
Yeah, we already talked about that. Yeah.
Oh man, well, it's a great story, JC, being able to go through what you went through, yeah, and now coming to grips with this career of yours. How does one reach you on social media, Twitter, and all that?
Everything, The Real JC, Facebook, The Real JC, YouTube is the Real JC Music. Instagram, The Real JC, Twitter, The Real JC One, the number one.
Right on.
You spell out J-A-Y, right?
J-A-Y-C-E-E. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. He was looking for me early and was like, "I can't find you."
And Miller says, "What's up?" And Clay, too, they're both on. I just texted them. They're, man, they wish I could be here right now, they said.
Oh yeah.
Shout out, man. Shout out. That's my family, man. My family, yeah.
We have Clayton coming in next week, and hopefully we could have Mila as well.
Yeah, yeah. Clayton William, huh?
Sounds good. All right, let's have a big round of applause for JC, everyone.
Yeah.
Come together. Let's have that sound effect there, Q.
Cue it up, Q.
Nothing?
The standing.
The standing hole.
All right, we're going to go ahead and take a quick music break and be back with
DJ Kubert here on the Slam Show. Hang tight. Oh yeah, that's Lil Bower and R.L. Grime, Infinite Daps here on the Slam Show. Welcome back. Yes, this is, I guarantee, everyone's excited about this segment of the program because we get to interview this gentleman here. I have a little sample video, and this comes from the documentary Scratch, one of my favorite movies. Because
we actually watched that together.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was getting schooled on some, you know, turntablists and all this DJ stuff. So mm-hmm. I had to watch it.
Gosh, look at that, man. How many years ago was that, Q?
I don't know, like 40 something.
Look at that.
And it looks about a year and a half old.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
And we're going to get into that because he has some secrets on how to stay young.
He must.
I know that for a fact.
I had no idea he was his age.
This gentleman, he is Bay Area born and raised out of Daly City, correct?
Or San Francisco.
San Francisco.
And then I moved to Daly City when I was like later. And when I moved to Daly City, that's when they made this film. And everyone was like, oh, he's from Daly City. But I'm actually from San Francisco.
There you go. Yeah.
And you still wear the hat the same way.
Yeah. We filmed that yesterday.
This gentleman is basically a brand name throughout the world, has developed DJ into a high-end culture that, believe it or not, if he his ass was never, ever existed, would never have gotten to where it's at today. That's the truth. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for DJ Q-bert.
Yeah!
Wow. I remember seeing you, and me and Stallion were talking about this, on Home Turf.
Oh, man.
When you Dominique!
Did that. Yep. Doing that appearance.
Gave away my age.
Shit, all our ages. Fuck, I was watching Home Turf every day after school. I was going, gotta watch Home Turf.
Damn.
Brother, when you were on there and
what,
you were
what
doing...
Is, what is Home Turf?
Exactly. I was going to say, what's Home Turf?
I remember that. Oh, man. You got to play the commercial. Got us. Can you remember the song, too.
Exactly. Seeing you on there was like, man, this guy, he's doing it. He's making DJing the way it's supposed to be, being creative and doing the whole mixing thing, because it wasn't yet coined turntablism at that point. And I'm not going to go into all the stuff you could Google right now and find out on YouTube, because they could know about your history and stuff. I'm going to ask the certain things that are a little bit more remarkable, and people are kind of like, wow, that's a crazy thing to ask, Q-bert. And I'm going to ask it, because that is what's out there that hasn't been asked yet. You got to understand, bro, you have really worked hard to brand your name, whether it's through the terms that you created, the scratches you've created, all this stuff with the turntable, the QFO, all this stuff. Have you ever pinched yourself and said, oh, my God, am I actually dreaming? Seriously, because you've done so much for the hip hop DJ culture. There's no words to describe it, brother. You're a living legend.
You're saying I'm old.
You could be a legend. And
you might as well say he's ancient aliens. And he would love that, right?
Ancient aliens.
Ancient aliens.
Let's just coin that.
Well, you know, there's some you know that TV show? Some people say that it's a conspiracy. Like, they're actually putting out disinformation. Like, they don't want you to know what the real ancient aliens are. They're showing you, like, a fake ancient aliens.
Okay. So let's jump into that. What are they trying to keep on the under, if that's what's kind of like the little distraction there?
I don't know. We don't know. There's a lot of, like, different stories. Who knows what's real? But, you know, there's this, the new thing going on right now is that you know, we were seeded here as, and we were, like, they took the Neanderthals and they put some of their DNA in them to make them slaves, to help them create their I guess to help them build the pyramids or whatever. And then after a time, they're like, okay, let's destroy the humans now. We don't need them, you know. And then the good extraterrestrials were like, no, we got to keep them. So let them evolve and let them become like us. And the evil aliens were like, no, we don't need them no more. You know, they're slaves. And so that war has been going on till this day, like with, like say, Fukushima.
Oh, I heard a lot about that.
Yeah, so, like, you know, if you notice in the last whatever decades, that you can't launch a nuclear missile anymore, because if you launch a nuclear missile, a small UFO out of nowhere will come and turn it off. And so the evil aliens are like, let's do it underwater. So they did the tidal wave for Fukushima, like that. They did an underwater nuclear bomb there.
Interesting. In connection to the Fukushima thing, right now there's that dispersing radiation that's going out into the Pacific. You heard about that, right?
Sure,
and it's kind of like keeping out of the mainstream news, but it's like something
it's
serious.
Coming here.
Yeah.
And can't fish no more.
That's crazy, man. Mm. And
it's crazy how on the news, like, the little red line that just seems so minuscule is the most important shit that you need to see, but they got the front. You know, they give you what you want, what they want you to see, and maybe small detail at the bottom. Oh,
thank you.
Obama launches nuclear warhead. I'm like, oh, fuck, what did that say?
Yeah.
Why is this on TV?
Why is there a Walmart thing up on there?
Yeah, right. Sorry for the person that got shot at Walmart, but what the fuck?
Exactly. That's the misinformation that the main media wants you to
diversion.
Kind of, yeah. Because
propaganda. Yeah.
They have that control.
But according to Area 51, this never happened.
You would know.
Daily.
You were there.
That's what I'm saying.
Well, to kind of get back to the whole Q-bert branding stuff, out of all the stuff that you put out, like I before mentioned, what are things that you want to start having done, say, the next 5 years that you haven't tapped your hands into, but you want to start creating and putting the Q-bert name on?
Well, we're doing another, I did a film a long time ago called Wave Twisters, which was a hip hop cartoon movie. Every chapter was a song in the album, so we're doing another one of those right now. It's been, I don't know, over
like over a dozen years that I've done something like that. So we're going to do that again. In between, I've been doing a lot of teaching. We have the school and all that. But now, you know, it's actually right now on the 16th, we're having the record release party for the two albums. It's two albums. One is with a bunch of MCs and the other one is a bunch of instrumental, like scratching things like
turntable stuff.
Yeah. Well, okay. Both have, you know, turntable stuff on it.
Oh, cool. Cool.
Yeah. So it'll be at the 16th at where's this now? California Academy of Sciences. You know, go there and check out the aquarium and enjoy some good music.
We're going to be there.
Nice.
That's for damn sure. Yeah. We're going to cover that. So outside of all your successes, it's not always going to be roses and great things happening. Talk about some of the disappointments that you had to overcome getting to where you're at now.
Well, I mean, you know, life is a balance. So for every defeat, there's going to be a win, you know. So I kind of look forward to the bad days because I'm like, all right, cool. That means a good day is going to come next or whatever. If I'm, you know, if I don't learn something that day, you know, it'll be like, okay, I will the next day. So it's always like, you know, you look forward for the positive when the negative comes around. So it's just life is just like that.
Is there a specific incident that you may have come across, like, gosh, whether it's an event that you DJ'd or a product that you endorse and you got screwed on? Can you go in specifics with that?
The easiest one for me is being lazy, like, you know, playing too much video games or just, you know, not getting to work and not practicing. Right. That messes me up. So I always have to stay on top, and I know now to always practice all the time, you know, not overkill. Of course, you know, you don't want to overdo it, but, you know, you got to get that in, though, you know, to, you know, it's like a boxer, sort of, because scratching is, you know, like it's like a jazz musician. Like Coltrane would play before the show, during the show, and after the show. And so we kind of look at scratching like that. That it's like kung fu. It's really a serious thing. Like right now, I'm like, damn, I want to get out of here and practice. I just came by to see you and have a good time. Chill.
That's right. And preparation is very important. It's just like an NBA player. You see LeBron James right before the game starts. He's shooting. And after the game, he's still doing the same thing.
That's right.
And vocal warmers before a show.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I want to ask you, how do you get your vocal cords prepared? You were talking about some drink. Explain that. That was cool.
The singing remedy or the hotty toddy. Yeah. I was actually introduced by that by my mom, but everybody knows it. It's just regular tea or honey tea for me. Lemon, whether it be the squeezed lemon or actual lemon. Sometimes I'll put a cough drop in there, the honey cough drop, just to give it that extra kick. Yeah. And then a shot of like Hennessy or bourbon or something, just to loosen you up. And then if you're sick or you have a fever, the Hennessy, it make you sweat all that up.
And you said, like, if you don't want your vocal cords to be messed up, don't drink cold water.
Cold water, yeah. You always want to drink room temperature water.
Yeah, that's dope. Yeah.
Cool.
You don't want to singe your cords or freeze your cords before a show.
Yeah, that goes with scratching too. Like before, I don't like it when my hands are cold, so I put it in warm water. I learned from a musician and it gets you more loose.
Oh, really?
Wow. Yeah. Nice.
Before you do any practice or performances?
Yeah,
or
sure.
Both?
Yeah, warm water. It's nice. Keep your hands, muscles all loose and flexible.
Gosh.
One of these days, you're going to scratch underwater.
What's that?
Scratch underwater. That'd be your next trick. Underwater.
Underwater scratching.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hook that up.
Where's my sound effect thing?
So, outside of all the music stuff, you got a lot of interest. Art, you're into a lot of the paranormal and extraterrestrial beliefs and so forth. What kind of compelled you to say, hey, this is something that's very interesting, I want to go ahead and devote some time? You mentioned listen to Alex Jones, Coast to Coast AM. I do the same thing. I think in a very honest opinion about it, I believe in what you believe in terms of we are seeded from a different planet of some sort and we're just put together on the earth and dispersed in a certain way, and we are who we are. Because if you look at certain people, you're like, wait a second, they could be brothers, but they're not brothers. Mm-hmm. See, so where does the connection become?
Y'all look alike.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think in a lot of ways you are on point with that. But get into detail how that came about in terms of how you said, hey, yes, I do believe in this whole type of culture.
Well, for me, it was, you know...
Was it from an experience? You seen something? You...
Well, when I was a kid, I always wanted to know, like, you know, where do we come from and what's going on here? What's the afterlife, all this stuff? And later, as I got into music, I was like, okay, wow, there's weird Turkish music. That's cool. There's weird Iranian music. Wow, Indian music is amazing. Well, what's, you know, what kind of music do they have out there? And so the internet had just popped up, like, in the early 90s, and I I got a computer. I was like, all right, what's alien music like? So I would check that out. And I wouldn't get to hear anything, but it would be stories of how they would live out there and how their culture is and all that. And I was like, wow, that's cool. That's how they should be on Earth. You know, they're really, you know, peace loving. We're really like kind of warlike over here. And we haven't figured out that we're supposed to work together. Knowing it, you know, everyone's kind of hypnotized by the media and, you know,
the rat race of lifestyle and so forth.
Yeah, sure. It's like
I think EDM music is like alien music.
Well, going back to what you're saying about aliens, I do remember a segment on Ancient Aliens that they launched a vinyl out there somewhere, and if an alien sees it, it's like, oh, okay, it's music. It's a universal language
That's
of
right.
everybody. And, yeah, and I wanted to ask you about that. Do you agree with that?
We're actually going to make a picture disc that looked like that for the album coming out right now.
Ooh, yeah. There you go.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. What's his name? I did that. The guy from Nova. What's his name?
Sagan.
Sagan. Carl yeah. Sagan. Yeah.
You heard Will.i.am just launched like a song up to a satellite, and it transmitted down from the satellite in space.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That's dope.
Just recently.
Yeah. Yeah. So a lot of musicians, a lot of DJs, they have this perspective that is kind of out there. But at the same time, there is some grounded truth to it. And I remember in Scratch, the documentary, you were mm-hmm. talking about scratching in general being a connection of a way of communication to a certain degree. Who's to say that it isn't? That's the thing. Yeah. And to be able to execute crab scratches and transforms and all that, that is a technique that not everyone could do. What if you were able to make that the sound that makes things kind of connect with something extraterrestrial or ultra dimensional? Who knows?
Yeah, who knows? We could be like a fish tank right now, and there could be beings here looking at us right now, but we don't see them, and they're just,
that's right,
you know, there's so many possibilities.
I've and said that so many times yeah. to people, because we only have five senses mm-hmm. and those five six. Senses doesn't command everything around us.
Six
Well, and Steve, that's another thing. In school, they teach you only five senses.
Six, right? If you could see ghosts.
Yes, your thinking. What about, you know,
ESP, yeah.
Your memory, everything. There's so many other zillions of senses that the school, they don't teach you. And that's how they train you at a young age. You know, they want you to not know all the secrets, so that you're just a slave for the rest of your life. But for those that have smoked marijuana, I don't want to say to smoke marijuana, but marijuana is one thing that will unlock like a lot of the hypnosis, and that's another reason why it was illegal too, is because it'll be like, oh, they're gonna find out about our secrets.
I don't think it's marijuana; it's the ayahuasca leaves that Homer was talking about.
Yeah, that's another one
that you get from Peru.
Sure, shrooms,
peyote,
all that stuff. Yeah,
ayahuasca.
There's actually a movie that he takes a pill and he unlocks his Limitless. You seen that yet?
Yeah,
I like that movie.
It's a good movie.
Yeah.
Good movie.
Yeah, and obviously there are some natural things that can kill you, and some stuff that you're just mentioning that's natural out there in Peru.
And it doesn't have to be marijuana. You could just meditate, and you know, you can unlock like secrets of life. You know, I'm not trying to say to go smoke or anything.
And that goes for a lot of different things too, as far as even art. Same thing with artists and art. Look at all the stuff that's out there now with the internet. You can see all the people's creativity, and you look at it and go, there ain't no way he did that straight, because it's so bizarre. Right. Yeah. And it's sure. a creative outlet with music and as well as with art.
And there are some people that are gifted that don't need any drugs.
Yeah.
That are,
oh,
like,
yeah.
They
no,
can
no.
just tap into
yeah.
that world yeah. already.
And in connection to that, you did some artwork, right? And was that under any type of
me?
Thing?
I drew.
Well, there's like a Cuber art thing, right? Or
no, we hire other people.
Okay,
yeah.
Those people, did they go ahead and
a lot of them do, and a very few of them don't. Like some I know a lot of scratchers, they, you know, smoke, and I know a few that are incredible and they don't. Like this guy Toads, DJ Toad Style, he doesn't do anything. I'm like, damn, you're in there, bro. It's like amazing.
That's dope.
Yeah, there's a lot of guys like that.
Let's talk about the new generation of DJing. Obviously, let's just go ahead and admit it, except for JC, that we come from the old school. Vinyl, 8-tracks, cassettes,
damn.
We're existing.
Phonograph.
Phonograph.
Wow. Right here.
Your Fisher-Price first toy, right?
As we all started with.
The Fisher-Price, yep.
Today's DJ, they have all the privileges that we should have had back then, not being able to carry crates of records or even go to the record store. What's your thought about the 12-year-old that's getting into DJing, what would be the first thing you would tell that 12-year-old to get him on the right track, to know where his ancestors and generations before came from, and also to be creative moving forward?
Well, first of all, yeah, you would ask him, so what are you trying to do? You know, and he might not even care about the ancestors, so it's like, why even tell him that? You know, if he's a nerd and he wants to know about that stuff, yeah, then I'll tell him. And then if he just wants to DJ and play parties, that's fine. But if he wants to scratch, that's a different thing. That's mm-hmm. like, you know, then you're getting into the musical instrument nerd stuff. Then I'll
go deep into things. It. Yeah.
But if he just wants to mix, oh yeah, boom, 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 you can mix. Just press the button. There you go. You're good.
Gotcha.
You know, but you know, if he wants to get into the kung fu arts of you know, scratching, that's another thing. It really depends on what their goals are.
Gotcha. And that's all connected to the Scratch University program that you have. So when
that's if I can't reach them, then we have a school for people to reach me online, and we have, like, you know, 500 students around the world that I can talk to and give them lessons and stuff.
Let's get into that. That's obviously, you just pointed out, it's online. What are some of the things you look for in a student and what they bring to the table?
You know, it really depends on where they're at. I see, you know, of course, if they're going to join the school, they're going to want to, you know, get into scratching. So they'll send me a video of themselves.
Mm-hmm.
I'm doing something for a couple minutes, and then I'll take them to, you know, their next level of what they can do after that.
That's cool.
Yeah. And can you teach an old dog new tricks?
Yeah. Yeah. We have students in there that are like in their 50s and 60s, actually.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, let's not go into the 50s. Let's keep it under a little under 50.
Right. Okay.
Right.
Yeah. Two of the students there won the last world championships.
The DMC?
Yeah.
IDA
championships.
Yeah. Oh, shoot. That's.
Yeah. Actually, no. He did win the DMC like last year. In fact, yeah. World Supremacy DMC.
And obviously, they had to tell Q-Bert and Invisible Scratch Pickles, no longer, because you're kicking everyone's ass. Remember the early days?
That's just a joke.
Man, when I saw
kicked
those...
them out, huh?
When I saw those videos, I was like, man, there's no way that these gentlemen could be beat, because they were just so many years ahead with their techniques of mixing and scratching and everything. It was just beautiful. You're just basically an honorary guy when it comes to that. You could just show up and they're like, oh, they'll bow down and boom, done deal. Q-Bert, can't beat that.
So, that's not like that.
So, yeah, I mean, as far as the whole, let's get back to the,
sure,
to you about how you prepare for things and so forth.
Yeah.
Dude, you look like you just came out of high school. What is the secret? I have a certain way of trying to keep myself young, working out, eating well, but are there things that you could add on to, like, regular regimens that people could pick up online?
I mean, I don't think I look younger or whatever, but I mean, some
yes,
things
do
help.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
a lot of spring water, that can help. A lot of
specifically spring water, right?
Bottled spring water. You don't want the plastic PVC things in there.
Okay.
You know, 8 hours sleep a day at least.
Okay, we got to trash all the freaking bottles now. Go
yeah,
spring.
Yeah, it's all in this garbage.
Yeah, and then, you know, you got to bless your water. You got to tell it what, you know, because water also holds intelligence. So, you know, there's a study, Dr. Morimoto. You heard about that?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. So, like, you know, like if you write a message on the bottle of water, like peace and love or whatever you want, you know, you can put those molecules under a microscope and look at the atomic structure, and you'll see that it turn into like a snowflake. Then if you write down like sick or disease, you look at the under a microscope and it'll be all like broken. So your body is 80% or 70% water. So you got to tell yourself, yeah, you know, I'm healthy, you know, I'm all positive, whatever. And you know, since you're mostly water, it's gonna be like that. You know, your atomic structure will become nicer if you give yourself positive reinforcements or whatever.
Quick question.
Yes,
since we're talking about water, have you tasted diamond water?
No, what is that?
Oh, because I was watching Shaw's of Sunset, and one of the girls makes diamond water, and I'm just kind of curious about it.
Wow.
Yeah, so maybe that's something you should check out.
You know, that reminds me, you know, gold. You know why the reason why gold is so expensive?
Why?
It's because it's food for your soul and spirit. It's actually, you can ingest gold And it
yeah, the edible like flakes.
Yeah.
That they put on cakes.
Yeah. So some people when they would get sick.
Put in alcohol.
Yeah.
Back don't they have that in Jägermeister or something?
No, the Goldschlager.
Yeah. You don't add alcohol to. But
that's crazy.
But in the back in the days they would put a gold coin in water and let it sit there overnight and you would drink that if you're sick. And the gold would...
The properties of the gold
would...
Isn't
it because it's ionic and, you know, the ionic water?
Like, has monatomic properties. Like, you can look at that online. There's silver as well, bronze. And these precious metals are actually expensive for that reason. Mm. But people don't know that.
Interesting.
Even just wearing them?
Like, yes, wearing them too. They can suck into your body, you know.
So the real gold, not the fake stuff.
That's right.
Not the
stuff that turns green.
You get a green mark on your neck.
That's why some of the bad rappers go crazy because they're wearing the fake shit, right?
Yeah. Well, Q, I'm going to go ahead and have my air personality staff ask you a question. We're going to start with Sage, Stallion, Miles, and then JC. Cool. Take it away.
Well, you pretty much answered most of the question throughout your interview. So let me think of one real quick. Oh, yeah. I know you've traveled throughout the country, overseas, lots and lots of places. Which venue has given you the best VIP treatment ever? Like, just a snap of a finger, it's like, they're there, you want it.
Wow, that depends.
It's like, easy, all of them.
Yeah.
A lot in the States, a lot in Europe, in Japan, in Australia a lot.
Okay, which is your favorite? Where is the favorite place where you actually not only worked at but vacationed that gave you that best VIP treatment?
Oh, I mean they're all nice. But for vacation, Hawaii, of course, you know, we moved there. Me and my girl, we like to, there's a really big community on like health food and spiritual stuff there, and we like to go there a lot. And she's what do you call it? Into like health coaching and fitness and all that, and so,
okay, yeah. Good.
That's probably the best place, Hawaii.
Paradise.
That's actually a about chakras, the energy points in our body.
That's right.
So the earth is also a living creature, and it has chakra points. If you type in earth chakras, you see that Hawaii, there's an earth chakra there too. And that's why the energy there is amazing.
Man, we're just going to have to go grab Homer real quick because yeah. This would be such a powerful connection with him.
He's already coming. He knows that we were talking about him. So
yeah, you're listening.
He's going to teleport.
He's teleporting over here right now. So who was the first person you saw, like, scratch on a record, and you're like, damn, I want to do that shit?
Oh, well, I think it was DST on Saturday Night Live. But in front of me, like, live was, like, Mixmaster Mike, my partner. He's the DJ for the BC Boys. And when we were kids, he started a month before me. So, you know, he was like, checks out. And I was like, God damn. He was way advanced. For a kid.
Now, if you could help these companies out that are putting out like Serato and Traktor and all these different DJ programs, which one of these companies would you want to work with, and what could you do to help them tweak it to make it better and more realism instead of like a digital sound? Like, you know, because a lot of these units that you buy now, they have a little digital sound. They don't even sound like a real record. Mm. Unless you spend a lot of money, you get ones that sound exactly like a record. But what's one company that you said, man, I want to work with them to help them? Because I know that Pioneer is like the number one brand name for DJs out there, especially the new kids that are was waking up, hey, well, I want to be a DJ, jump on a Pioneer, and never touch a turntable in their life. So they're just getting that digital feel right away. But what company would you want to help make it better, but you put your stamp on it?
You know, all of the companies, they always make all these turntables and stuff, and we're going to the NAMM show, and I'm like, hey, dude, put a fader on the turntable. Put a fader on the turntable. I tell all the companies, put a fader on the turntable. So
yeah.
It's like, damn, you know, so you could just already, boom, right away. You know, portability. I wish I could just, boom, right here and have a turntable
QFO.
With a fader. Yeah,
QFO.
Yeah, and we're working with this company right now, DJ Tech. We just made a limited edition mixer with our company, Thud Rumble.
Mm.
If you go to, like, DJCuber.com or ThudRumble.com, you'll see it. And at the NAMM show, we're going to, you know, show some crazy surprises.
Dope.
Yeah, I did see some new turntables. Somebody was, I don't know if you see it online. It's like a 1200, but it's digital. It's got all the, you know, the buttons and faders and everything else on it. But it's got the record, the needle, but it's like totally digital. I forgot what company it was. It just came out. It's crazy looking.
Yeah, so, like, I mean, a lot of things are because, you know, people love to scratch analog. Yeah. People love to scratch digital because you could do, you know, scratch all the sounds right now that are in your library. But people want the balance of it too. So, well, like us. We want both. So we made these records like with Traktor. So one side will be analog the other side will be like a tractor control tone. So it's like best of both worlds.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
That's, you know, Rain is doing that. And, you know, a lot of companies are like, whoa, that's, you know, that's the future. It's kind of like,
yeah, you got to put your one of yours for Rain too, because I know how they, the DMC came out with one. One side was, you know, the Serato signal. The other side was music. So
sure. Yeah. Right now we're doing one with a DJ A-Track. He's doing his one of his songs on one side, and the other side is a tractor control tone.
Nice. Yeah. Cool.
Duck sauce.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
All right. I know you scratched and battled with a lot of people over the years that you've been doing this, because I hear it's a lot of years. I won't ask you how many. Again, out of all those years, what's the most memorable battle that you had with somebody, and what made it that fun that you can remember it? What was that one thing that made it that way?
I think we used to battle a long time ago, the DMC World Competition, and back then, before we entered the competition, we were strictly concentrating on the sound of it all and how it sounds musically and how it's playing the turntable like a musical instrument. But before we got there, a lot of people were doing like body tricks and gimmicks and scratching with, you know, vibrators and dildos.
And, oh my God. Their asses.
Fake penises.
Their tongues and shit.
Yeah, things like that.
Jumping
taking
up and
their
down.
Pants down, putting their fader in their asses. You know, so there was a lot of gimmicky stuff, and they would win the competition because of that, you know. Scratch naked, anything, whatever the was like. It wasn't even musical anymore. It was more just like, wow, that's funny, ha ha ha, you know.
Yeah.
And then we get like a big audience response. And I entered one of those competitions and I lost. I like went all the way to the world finals and I took second place because I wasn't doing it. I was just being a musician.
You didn't take off your shirt?
Actually, I did. No, I did. But then, but when people saw that video, they were like, hey, wait a minute. That guy that lost, he was kind of doing something musically. Like, oh, hey, you know. So when I entered the next year, I entered with Mixmaster Mike and Apollo as a DJ band type of thing. And they were like, okay, we get it now. You guys are doing something musical. Okay, cool. So we won that competition. We won the world championships by being musical. And so from then on, there was no more vibrators and dildos. It was boring because we kind of messed it up for everybody. So we're going to bring the vibrators and dildos back.
Nice. For the exotic rock ball, right?
That's right, yeah.
I have another quick question. Besides your crew you roll with in the city, who's one person out there you always had battles with out in the Frisco that it's a well-known name that you guys always like went head-to-head and there was always at the competitions giving you like the run for your money, but you always came up on top? Is there anyone that you know of?
I don't know if I've came on top, but... That's what she said.
Did you ever like battle? Like,
what's that?
Did you ever like battle like anybody like Joe Cooley or anybody like?
No one's super huge like that. Yeah, Jazzy Jim, he was like the large, like the big DJ out here.
So do you guys do work together too?
No, I would love to do some work with them.
So you guys battled actually?
We battled a couple times, you know, friendly battles and
okay,
stuff.
Okay.
Skyway Sounds.
Yeah. That's Jazzy Jim, what's up? I know his brother too, right? You know his brother?
Oh, Archer. I know Jim from the radio just back in the day. Okay. Yeah, he was kind of my boss back in the day. So, but
and then of course, besides Mixmaster Mike and Apollo, there was also the crew: Shortcut, Yoga Frog, D Styles, mm-hmm. Flair, Disc. You know, everybody out here.
That's right.
Quest was dope.
Lazy Boy just tuned in. What's up?
A lot of guys. DJ Mar.
Yeah.
A lot of people.
Can I squeeze in a question? I'm sorry.
Sure.
Go ahead, JC. I'll squeeze it in after him.
Go ahead.
Okay. If you weren't doing the music and not being this entrepreneurial super DJ, what would your 9-to-5 job be?
Ooh, that's tough. Because my mom told me when I was younger that we would do a lot of vandalism and graffiti and throw newspapers and cars that would light it first and throw it in there and come back after a piece of car being on fire. And we did a lot of bad stuff like that. My mom always said that, hey, you know, you have a lot of talent. And all these crazy guys out there, they're really talented, but they just put it in a negative way. Mm-hmm. And so when I discovered turntables and scratching, I used all that negativity into a positive. And I'd probably be locked up, you know, doing stupid negative things and evil things.
The one that gets caught.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, so all you crazy guys out there, you know, do something.
Positivity.
Yeah. Positive. You know, you have a lot of talent, but you just don't know it.
Behave. Plain and simple.
And don't do drugs.
And if you notice, even the most hardcore gangsters, man, they're the sickest poppers or the sickest rappers. You know, it's awesome. They just don't know to, you know,
challenge.
Throw that karma out there and it comes back to you. You know.
Well, back in the day, we didn't have the avenue. They didn't have the avenue that they do now. Now you have the avenue of the
YouTube. YouTube is amazing. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
Cool. JC.
So, all right, two questions. We talked about it earlier. So you broke a vinyl in half and scratched on that. What triggered in your mind, or what event made you say, all right, you know, I got to switch it up real quick and give these people a wow factor? How did that come about?
Add on to that is when you grabbed the Tonar and you made the scratching sound just going over the record.
Yeah.
You know, all of that stuff was...
How'd you come up with that?
All that is when I partnered up with Mixmaster Mike at a young age. We were 15 years old. And I asked, hey, Mike, how do you get good? You know, what's the secret? And he said, dude, just be original and make up your own rules. That's the whole secret. I was like, oh, okay, cool. So then there was no rules anymore. So we made up anything, and anything goes. And then I saw this guy, Christian Mark Clay, who's not a DJ, but he just makes all these weird sounds on records and puts tapes records together and plays them. And so I was like, wow, this guy's crazy. So I took that and, you know, added that into scratching and battling.
Right.
And, you know, I kind of just ran with making up your own style with, you know, we would imagine, like, what would the craziest guy on planet Zorlon do? And we would just imagine and make jokes and, you know, and... We were like, oh, that's actually a good idea. Let's try it.
Yeah. The first time I saw that where you took the tone arm, put it on the record, and just start scratching with the tone arm, I was like, Mike.
Christian Mark Clay, watch him. I took a lot of ideas from him.
There you go.
Try to redo it in my way.
All right. And
then second question.
Yeah.
So you're known. You're like Sam and all of us have already said, you're a legend. What one or two or three, top three, what top three things can you say that you're so proud of that this is why you're legendary?
I think I don't even think I'm legendary. Oh, I'm legendary because.
Well, okay, so then why would you say?
You sound like Barney from How I Met Your Mother. Legendary.
Why would you say that? What are the top three things that people would tell you that they feel you're legendary for?
I think that some good points I would like people to know is. You know, I see all these guys like, oh, I did it already. I did it. It's not like that. You know, I think for me and for a lot of artists, you know, to remain a student and always learn and, you know, that's just how it is. You just,
definitely.
Success is not a one thing. It's like, it's a constant
evolution
of learning. You're always going to learn something, you know, until we reincarnate and get sucked back into God's spirit that we know everything. We're not going to do that, you know, in this lifetime. So we got to keep on.
Progress.
Yeah, keep on being happy about, you know, the progression of things that you learn, and the negativity turns them into positivity, and, you know, everybody's bored now.
No, roll with it.
But and another thing would be, you know, I like you were saying about YouTube and stuff, and people are always worried about money and all this stuff, and right now money's kind of getting phased out, and a lot of people are doing things for trade now, and they're starting to learn about karma, and that money really is just an illusion. You can never throw away money or give away money or take money. You always end up with what the universe, you know, knows you deserve.
Well, which is supposed to have.
Yeah. So
you can never take it with you.
Yeah.
Ask definitely. Steve Jobs.
Yeah, totally. And so if you want money, money is just energy, really. So if you want that stuff, all you got to do is just
manifest it.
You have to manifest it, but at the same time, you got to give. So if you want a whole bunch of money, you got to give a whole bunch of stuff out to people. And that's what's so beautiful about YouTube, because YouTube hits like zillions of people. And the new money in the future is not really money. It's called notoriety. So the more known you are, the more you can give out to people, and that just keeps coming back to you. And so that's what people should be doing for the rest of their life, is trying to find out an invention or something that will make the world a better place. Because if you just make a few people happy, you're only going to get that much
back.
Energy, money, or back. So this is great. You have a radio show. This reaches out to the whole world.
Yeah.
And that's why you got those new shoes. And
we're a non-profit.
No, but that's why. It doesn't matter. Money is just an illusion, right? It's going to come back to you. You know.
I got one to add.
Yeah.
If you today had to pick one thing from your past or your present, what's the one thing you want people to know you for?
Hmm. Mm.
This vandalism.
I think the
my 64 Chevy I blew up.
I think just the notion that the ultimate evil is selfishness and the ultimate happiness is in giving.
Okay.
Well said.
That works.
Well said.
And one more to add, the name Q-Bert. Was you playing the video game Q-Bert? No, damn, I like that.
No,
that's
it was
me.
It was my last name starts with a Q.
Okay.
And at the time, like Pac-Man and Q-Bert and Dig Dug were the main video games. And so some guy was like, oh, Q-Bert. And it just stuck everybody's.
Oh, great.
Yeah, like, no, I'm DJ Ripclaw. Whatever. No, hey, Q-Bert. No, that's not my name.
What was your name in the past?
Yeah, I wanted to be like some silly name, DJ Trix or DJ whatever.
Tornado. Well, what was it? Were you known as somebody?
I had all these names, but I was never known for any of those names.
Yeah. Q-Bert was the one that stuck.
That's some terrible notoriety right there.
Yeah, I'm fighting that battle myself. Yeah.
Oh well.
We got a nickname for him, but we can't figure out which one. Every Monday it's a different name, so.
Yeah, we're trying to find one that sticks. So far, what were they?
Gramps. Double Dip.
D squared. Cupcake D squared.
Mac.
Yeah. Maybe or Mac Q. Miles seems to be the one that. Huh.
Maybe Q could come up with one and he will select
and
it.
And JC, please help us out.
Yeah. Well, Q, we have a track here. It's queued up. It's called Bullet. Can you tell
me? Oh, my God.
Bit?
Okay, that's just me and IQ practicing. We're just jamming. So I'm scratching the ah, and he's scratching all the other sounds in between. And then I go off and scratch for a long time. And so, you know, it's good. If you want to go to sleep, you can listen to it.
Is this off your up-and-coming album?
Yeah, I have two albums. One is the one bunch of MCs, which is the whole concept is like, sorry to interrupt, but the whole concept is like there's an outer space, whatever, federation of music.
Mm-hmm.
And then one of the albums is all a collection of their music in outer space from different planets. Each song is from a different whatever dimension or whatever extraterrestrial world. And then the other album is the Earth album, which a bunch of MCs, and this Earth was trying to hey, this is represents us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, let's roll into that. This is called Bullet by DJ Q-Bert. And
no, this is just it's just freestyle. I don't even know why there's a name on it. Hey. Is there actually a name? You named it.
No, that's all you, brother.
We're gonna DJ go IQ from Handroids.
There you go. Let's get into it here on the Slam Show.
We'll be right back.
Yeah, that was Bullet by DJ Cuber, a little freestyle. Here's the thing. The aw sound from Change the Beat, that has been used like a motherfucker for all DJs. It's a very simple sound, and everyone gravitates to it. There has to be another type of sound that people could gravitate to, because every single DJ does that for every single YouTube video, for every single viral thing. What's your take on that? Why it's been such? It's why it's stuck so long.
Two reasons. One is because it sounds cool, and the second reason is because you can judge their skill level by how they flip it. Like how. Well, you could hear like the difference. You know, with other sounds, you kind of like kind of are guessing a little bit. Like, oh, okay, well, you know, maybe is it the sound that's helping them do that? But with the eye, kind of can't cheat. It's just that one sound.
Gotcha. Yeah. But it's almost like a guy that's playing keyboard and he's just pressing C over and over again and he's just manipulating it. Yeah. I think some way, somehow, for future generations, we should have some type of variant sound.
There's tons. Yeah, like if when my album comes out, like there's like only two songs that have aw on it, and there's like 33 tracks.
Gotcha.
I'm scratching like a zillion other sounds.
Well, yeah, someone like you, you can manipulate anything. But for a novice, they always gravitate to the aw sound because it's easy and it conforms to their technique of how they want to scratch. But
or it's just, time.
Yeah, it's time too.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I'm looking forward to the album. And when does you're dropping two at the same time, correct?
Yeah.
When does that go out?
That's gonna be on the 16th at San Francisco Academy of Sciences.
Yeah. Okay, and that's like the release date where people could get it, like a hard copy or download.
It's a launch for our Kickstarter, so we can get the album out there and
the
film and all that stuff.
Oh, so it's a Kickstarter project thing.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So we have to contribute a little bit. All right, that's cool. That's what you're talking about.
Yeah.
The universe about giving, then you'll get back.
Right.
That's beautiful, brother. That's beautiful. All right, we're going to go ahead and go into our shouts and plugs to close out the show. We're going to go down the list, starting with Sage.
Well, this is a very fascinating show. I've never seen Slam so excited, so this is definitely the best of 2014. So shout out to Qbert, JC, and of course the crew, Slam, Stallion, and Mac Miles. And off camera we have Rich. And of course to all of our sponsors and affiliates, thank you for everything. Thank you for what you do for us. And go to TVEPN.com for a complete list. And just quickly, I want to play a quick word association with Qbert. Megatron or Optimus Prime?
Ooh. Damn.
You threw him off with the flashing there.
Miles. Megatron.
Yes!
I would have to, because if I had the toy, I would rather have that one.
That's all I needed to know.
Yeah, only because of the toy. That's why. Outfit looks better.
Okay.
Yes.
We might hook that up for him. Why not?
Awesome.
And scratching sounds for the new Transformers, the voices.
That's right. Yeah, that's
good idea. Dope. Yeah, shout out to our crew, Sam, Sage, Gramps. I got to call him Gramps.
Yeah, it works.
Every week
works.
Is different.
That works.
Of course, DJ Qbert, the legend, thanks for coming out. Man, it was good seeing you. Last time I seen you, I think, it was like you were battling in Walnut Creek.
Oh, damn.
Vertigo.
The shortcut there?
I think it was just you and somebody. I think Father MC performed that night, too. It was crazy.
Damn.
Father MC.
Late 80s.
Yeah, and JC, good meeting you. I heard a lot of good things. And then we got Clay coming next week. And Miller's on listening to us right now. Shout out to them as well. We have our sponsors, Hell Olympia, After Party, Kinders, Divinius, Little J Burgers, Drinkware Clothing, BPM Supreme, Natural Left Foods, Perfect Tan, Niner Empire. That's right, Niner Empire. We did it. Online listening, we got Rebecca, DJ Henry Customs, Kelly, Elisa, Lazy Boys on the line listening. We got Miller in the chat, Clay in the chat, my parents are in the chat, and the boy Rich in the corner over here just peeping everything out.
Our boy Rich.
Yeah.
Hard Rich.
There you go.
What's another name for Rich?
Dick.
What's his nickname?
HD.
HD. HD.
Miles.
JC, it was nice to meet you guys.
Thank you.
Right, Rich, nice. You're silent, quiet type.
Rich D. Right.
Those are the ones you got to be careful of.
Yeah, that's right.
HD will come out.
Like back in the day, there used to be hood ornaments. They were just there to look pretty. That's him right there.
You had that on your rules, huh?
And the crew, thank you very much. Been a great time. You guys have made it special. Sam has never smiled so much, I'll tell you. Mm-hmm. Well, maybe when the Niners won, but yeah, you know what? That's a close second. Yeah. So thank you guys for coming along and enjoying everything. So
thank you.
You made it
thank
a good good show.
Cool, cool. Niners won because Ric Flair came in there and pumped him up, man.
That was it. That's what I heard.
That was awesome. Legendary.
Old school WWE.
WWE. I mean, that's way back in the day. This is 30 right. years wrestler, like a 16-time world champion, came into the locker room.
The Nature Boy.
In Green Bay. And he's from Carolina, but Ric Flair said he's always been a diehard Niner fan.
And he wants them to play Carolina.
Yep.
And he got his wish. All
right. He wants them to beat the Seahawks.
It'll be an interesting one.
Oh, quick shout out to Party Trees, Party Girl Fetish. Thank you for my ring. I'm wearing it. I'm not
my
flipping
wife.
You guys off. it's an awesome ring that I got. So if you guys want it, go to partygirlfetish.com.
Yes.
There
you go. JC?
Yeah, obviously family first. So I'm in Pittsburgh. You know, everybody. All my Pittsburgh family, friends.
P World?
P World. Parkside baby. love you guys. Special shout out to my ladies watching at home and my son who I do this for, you know, and most of all my team, you know, Clay Miller, my manager Phil, Enzyme Nielli, Furious. I mean, they pushed me to be great, you know, and I'm happy to be a part of an entity that wants to grow in a positive direction. So, man, I'm excited for the 2014, man. Hand it over, man. If you ain't got it on iTunes, go get it.
Love it. And how can they follow you on social media?
Again, everything The Real JC. Twitter, The Real JC, number one. Facebook, The Real JC.
Spelt out.
Spelt out, yes, thank you again. JAYCEE. Instagram, The Real JC, same thing. And YouTube, The Real JC Music.
There you go. Okay. Mr. Q.
Thank you guys. Whatever. Thank God. Thank everyone. Come to the show if you're in the Bay. January 16th. California Academy of Sciences. Is that right? Is it San Francisco Academy of Sciences?
California
Academy of Science. Check out the Kickstarter launch for my two albums. And if you want to follow me, it's... at DJ Qbert, DJ Qbert, at DJ Qbert on Twitter or Instagram. And once again, thanks for having me on the show.
Thank you.
Yoga
thank
Frog, you. What's up? Thud Rumble.
Yeah, shout out to the Slam and Sam show, man. It's been a long time coming.
It's the Slam
show. Sorry. Slam and Sam was my first producer. So, you know, we go back and to see the relationship come from just a put together situation, us not knowing each other just through family, and then to where it is now a bond and a partnership. It's amazing to see. So thank you, man. Appreciate it.
Hey, one quick question for Q. Hey, on your launch party,
yes,
it's on a Thursday night. What time are you guys planning on
what time
kicking it off?
It starts at around 9, I think. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And I think it's $11 or $12 to get in. Whatever.
Oh, we're definitely there, the 16th.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Are you going to perform at all a little bit?
Yeah, do a couple of tracks from the album and you know, see what happens from there.
Breaking records?
probably.
and this Friday, I also have it's a ladies' night event. Ooh. At New Caribbean City. It's in Oakland.
Okay.
It's a really nice club. Big Dave Presents. Sauna G will be hosting. Mm. DC is chilling. Shay Diddy and Black Mark on ones and twos. So come out if you guys aren't doing anything on Friday.
And you're performing?
I'm performing. I'll be performing Stop Tripping, Hand It Over, and a few 90s joints.
All right.
All right.
There you go. Some covers there.
And
yeah,
and some more shies.
Some more shy. Yeah.
I think maybe, you should take us out
maybe some H-Town.
Yeah. Take us out with some Babyface at the end of the show.
Don't put too much pressure on him.
Close it down.
No pressure.
I'd like to thank my entire crew, Sage, Stallion, Mac Miles, our special guest, JC. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Very glad that you got your life all in a positive order and moving forward. And much success in the future and along with your family and everything.
Yeah, thank you.
And best wishes to your son. And
thank you.
And like I said, science is always evolving. Medicine is always evolving.
Yeah.
You never know what's going to happen.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's the damnest truth I can tell you.
Yeah.
That's
for sure. You know, real quick about that, you know, a lot of people don't understand what the Down syndrome is.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not retarded.
So I don't, if you approach me and say something's retarded, then I'm cutting off all communication, because, you know, that's a word I take offense to.
Correct.
But at the same time, I get to see him overcome so much, you know, things that the average human could not overcome. Mm-hmm. And just to see him overcome leaps and bounds, it just makes me even a prouder father and proud to be a father. And I couldn't have done it. Also, you know, my lady, she's at home, and she I work and she stays home, and they accomplish that together. So that's a team effort, you know. And I just, it's a blessing. So yeah, you know,
They're very intelligent, actually.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. You know, they focus in on one thing. Mm-hmm. Like all the songs on the radio, he knows. No bullshit, he knows every song on the radio. Mm-hmm. And he does this little turn up dance. He says "Act Right." And that's his favorite song right now, "Act Right" by Young Jeezy and YG. And he'll turn up, and like, he's just so animated, and you know, it's so beautiful to see, you know. And so Down Syndrome Connection, if you guys are considering, you know, trying to fund or sponsor or just
donate
something to a positive community, Down Syndrome Connection, they do a lot of things for the Down Syndrome community.
Excellent. Well said there, JC. Thank you very much for that info. And I'd like to thank everyone that's in the chat room interacting with us, all the viewers out there. Without you guys, there is no Slam Show. I'd like to thank also all the sponsors and affiliates that are on board. Your support is greatly appreciated. And be sure to like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter, TVEPN The Slam Show, which enables you to be part of our end of the show giveaway, which we're going to do right now.
Ooh.
And I will give the bowl to Rich, step over here.
While you're saying that real quick, I want to shout out to Mac Mall. He just says, with big what's up to Cubert, my
Mall,
boy.
What's up?
He just hit me up on Instagram, and he's all like,
right,
man.
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and stand right in between them and read out the
turn
winner.
Around. Luciano Ottavio.
Say that on the mic.
Luciano Ottavio.
All
you
right.
Are the winner.
Cool. Thank you, Rich.
What'd you win?
We're going to put together a little something-something that is connected to both JC and Cuber. That's beautiful. Beautiful.
And shout out to my three nieces. They're actually subscribed. So Carly, Raylin, and Maddie.
Excellent.
Thank you for awesome. Subscribing.
All right. All
and
right.
Watching.
All right, that does it for this episode. We're going to go out with Plan to Get Served by DJ Cubert.
And Tajo Pierce.
That's right. All right, for myself and everyone here on the program, we'll see you next week. Peace.
Peace.
How many MCs wanna fuck me? Not many, you a son of me. Might as well be living in my custody, cause you a bustard that's just looking up to me. Hut, hut one, hut two to the three. Keep it moving like I'm busting from a motherfucking Uzi. Whichever one is in front of me, when I bust the seat, it'll be the first one to cease. I'm a top and it's in a hip hop innovator, quicker than Q finger when he crossing a bit. Off in the hate of man, cause I'm still in the scene. I'm a lean, mean MC, grilling machine. Kill him with ease, similar to fleas on my nuts. I'ma smoke y'all quicker than the trees that I pop. Leave my enemies in the dust, debris and rust, gone with the breeze when I bust.
Plant. Plan to get plan to get served.
Dropping the rhyme, off of the top of the mind. Skin made of steel like Optimus Prime. I rush in like rhinoceros, so will not miss. Get left with no pot to piss. Determined to claim my throne with no concern for vermin. Lanes and clones, whole different plane that my brain is on. Came to change the game, got the range to do it. Entertain with music, you claim you're ruthless.